Hey guys, when alkali metals are placed in water, we are always on the brink of exploding. In this video, I'll demonstrate how we control this vigorous reaction to prevent explosions. The inspiration for this video came from an article in the well-known journal Applied Chemistry. I'll include a link to the article in the description. In short, we can observe a blue color of solvated electrons not only when alkali metals are dissolved in liquid ammonia, but also in water. Now I'm going to create a sodium-potassium alloy by mixing pieces of sodium and potassium in hot oil to showcase this effect. In one of my previous videos, where there was a moment when one drop absorbs another, some of you requested to show it in slow motion. Well, today I have the opportunity to show you it from different angles, including slow motion shots. If we add the resulting sodium-potassium alloy to liquid ammonia, we'll observe a characteristic blue color seen in ammonia solutions of alkali metals. Dropping a sodium-potassium alloy into water will result in an instant explosion, with sparks of burning metal flying around. Even if we carefully touch the water's surface with a drop of the alloy, it will ignite as well. But if we create an inert atmosphere and gently place a drop onto the water's surface, it will turn bright blue, just like when alkali metals are dissolved in ammonia. This allows us to observe a significant formation of solvated electrons visible to the naked eye despite their extremely short lifetime in water. To achieve a controlled, non-explosive reaction, I carefully place a drop of the sodium-potassium alloy on the water surface instead of dropping it from a considerable height, which always leads to an explosion. Additionally, we continuously flush the reaction vessel with inert gas to prevent the ignition of the hydrogen gas formed. Eventually, this drop will lose its color and explode. I was able to record this process in slow motion. After the reaction, a transparent drop of molten hydroxide temporarily stabilizes on the water surface via the land and frost effect before bursting spectacularly once it cools sufficiently. Moreover, the blue color of solvated electrons can be observed when the sodium-potassium alloy interacts with superheated steam. I have boiling water in a flask connected to a helical copper tube heated by an external gas burner. The steam passing through the coil reaches a high temperature, allowing it to ignite a match. Yes, I managed to light a match with water. In this experiment, I introduced lithium aluminum hydride to the superheated steam in the hopes of capturing stunning footage and extending the video's length slightly. When I put a sodium-potassium alloy into the superheated steam, it doesn't explode. However, you can clearly see dark blue areas forming on the drop. The referenced article provides spectroscopic evidence that the blue color, visible to the naked eye, is a result of electron solvation. Thanks for watching, guys, let me know in the comments if you were already aware of this phenomenon, because it was quite a chemical shock to me. A special thanks to all my patrons who support me. In the next video I'll showcase some explosive reaction of a sodium-potassium alloy with halogens. Don't forget to subscribe so you will not miss it. See you in the next video.